The Lounge with Chow. Neo Soul only.
Let's get straight into it. Karun, thank you so much for coming in.
No, it's my pleasure. I'm so glad.
I feel like I think I might owe Tom a cake or something.
And me.
And you. Oh, you want cake? Okay.
I want cake.
You want cake? Okay, we can make sure you get cake.
I have a sweet tooth, yeah.
You have a sweet tooth.
Yeah,
oh, it's not just
what about
me.
You? Yeah.
Oh my goodness, it's a problem, girl.
Yeah.
I'm scared of me.
Oh.
I'm scared of me and my sweet tooth. Tom, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Tom Olango has been very instrumental in ensuring that we get great guests into the studio. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Tom.
There's a backstory to
cake
this.
Cake for me.
Cake for you. There's a backstory to this, which is that I was working with Salif Keita for Kuruga Festival last week. And in the midst of that, I saw a video on Twitter. And it was you singing. And I saw Tom. He was on the guitar.
Okay.
And I just quickly got into shock and told, you know, the people that were around me, Salif's team, and I showed them, I said, this is what Kenyan music is, because they were asking me about Kenyan music, and
amazing.
I showed them. And they loved your voice. They gave you such great compliments in French.
Yay.
I don't know if I should say that. Ta voix est douce, très belle et magnifique.
My son speaks French, so he'll just translate.
Yes! Let's get Karun's son to speak French and tell mommy what was said. Is that true? That was probably a joke, right?
He's two, right?
He's 2 years old and speaks French. I love geniuses. I love geniuses.
That's a good man.
So thank you for coming. Thank you
oh,
for
my
coming.
Pleasure.
Yeah.
I'm so glad to have a space like this that like I can vibe with. It's my vibe completely.
It's your vibe completely?
Yeah.
Great. So let's, Karun, I don't know much about your backstory, and I don't always delve into that. But the first thing that got to me when I listened to your music is there's a story behind this young lady. There's something that she's been through that nearly broke her, but did not, and instead, light and sound came out.
Wow. What? Okay, well, I'm kind of glad you don't know my backstory, because I've been really just trying to start afresh. I'm sure some listeners know my background, also known as Miss Karun. I don't even know if that
No, I know you were in a group.
Yeah,
I know the group,
so
but just the personal stuff, I don't pay attention to.
Yeah.
But I feel like that's what I feel when I listen to your music.
Just basically since the end of that whole period of life, it's been like a whole searching, soul searching, kind of just like trying to grow up in my own right, but I'm kind of having this like whole public persona that people mistake me as, and it's just kind of you know, like how they say the age that you get famous as is the age that you stay. Like,
really? I didn't know that.
Yeah, people try to explain how Michael Jackson is the way he is, you know.
Uh-huh.
He's so soft-spoken and he's very childlike because he became famous at the age of like 5, right? Mm-hmm. So that kind of happens because it's hard to grow up in the public eye. So I kind of just left. I like left Kenya. I was in school. I like deleted my social media. I was not on Twitter because, you know, Kenyans on Twitter be cray.
Okay,
I hear
that.
I just needed like time.
You needed space.
Grow. Yeah, yeah. So it was, I won't get into the details, but yeah, it was hard and it was also amazing. So I don't know. Maybe that's what you hear.
The challenges that you face, like I said, I felt maybe could have broken you. Did music help?
I had to go all the way to the other spectrum of music because Kamula was pop. I kind of joined this group called Cosmic Homies, and we did very wavy, like electro organic. That's what we called it. It was very psychedelic. It was very, very not pop. So I just kind of had to find myself in different ways. And music did help, but there was actually a whole year of my life that I couldn't listen to music at all. So I just like went to art, design, just like all these other things that helped inspire me to like kind of distract myself from the fact that I couldn't listen to music. Like I physically couldn't listen to music. Like it would make me sick. So
you needed a break from everything that had
just
happened.
Too much, because like music is my passion and I know it's what I want to do for the rest of my life, but it was just a bit traumatizing for that year.
Yeah. So you found another way to create.
Yeah, yeah. Through art
and express
design,
yourself.
Tattoos.
Yeah, I love that. Do you do tattoos?
Yeah. Well,
you can design tattoos?
Yeah, but I kind of stopped. But
okay. Hidden skills. Hidden skills. I love that. So every time, you know, somebody comes into the station or on the show, the first thing I ask is for them to perform. Now, in the previous hour, I played your song Roses, which I'm in love with, just so you know.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I'm going to ask Tom to put it on, you know, start it on his guitar. And could you please, please, please perform it for us right now?
Yeah, my pleasure. Yeah. over your skin, let me breathe. Floating fingers over your skin like I know you wanna see me. I always wanna wake up like that, roses on my bed, be my medicine if you say it like you said. I never knew love like that, I never knew love, yeah. Tell me, babe, how could this be? Oh yeah. I think we had the same dream. You speak my language, babe. You see me better than anyone's ever seen, ever seen. You took your time, babe. How you been? How you been? I never knew love like that, I never knew love, yeah. You got me over the moon like where's my head at, someone help me. You put me on like I said, we one in the same, oh it's insane. No, I feel like I've been blind. You're my type of guy, you're my guiding light, yeah. Yeah, over your skin, let me breathe. Floating fingers over your skin like I know you wanna feel me, yeah. Go deep, yeah. We could be all night drunk texting, babe, how you be? And we could be all day romancing, babe. You see me, you see me, you see me. Better than the thoughts and the sea. Better, I knew I never seen, never seen. I never knew love like that, I never knew love, yeah. Thank you.
Oh wow. Like, how do you just sound exactly like the record? I'm just
I guess Ukweli did something right, the producer.
Yeah. And you're doing something right too. I feel the same emotion I felt when I heard
it. Never seen, never seen. I never knew love like that. I never knew love, yeah.